All right, there's a few things I want to go over real quick. First off, a happy 2020. 2019 is finally over. It was a pretty quick year, to me at least. And another thing I want to say is I haven't uploaded in a while because I don't have a lot of ideas. Plus, school has been harder, but I have a break. I guess I just don't have ideas. And another thing I want to say is Christmas Eve was 1 year anniversary of my 1,000 subscriber channel getting deleted, so that's not good. But yeah, starting off with this list, you can see the title, you know what it is. Number 10 is The Exterminator at Kennywood. This is a really fun indoor ride. There's this moment at the end of Ejector. It flung me out of my seat so hard. I was not expecting this at all. Overall, it wasn't exactly as good as I thought it would be, but it was still really fun. And I think it's maybe a little underrated. I don't know. That Ejector moment on there is underrated. As you're like spinning, it's really fun. I love this ride. So, coming in at number 9 is Mighty Canadian Mind Buster at Canada's Wonderland. This is the only wooden coaster I rode at Canada's Wonderland, because they didn't ride Wild Beast or Wildebeest, whatever that thing's called. I heard this one is better, so good thing I chose this one over that one. People I was riding it with thought it sucked. I didn't think it was that bad, but I kind of went along with it, like, yeah, it wasn't that great, but it really wasn't that bad. I liked it. It was really rough, and rickety, and really fun. I loved it. Yeah, I think this isn't as bad as a lot of people say. Talking to you, Amusement Insiders. Number 8, Skyrocket at Kennywood. This slightly disappointed me. I mean, I didn't think this would be, like, a top-tier ride. But I thought it would be a little bit better, like, the inversions and the final airtime hills. I thought those would be a little bit better than they actually were. But the top hat is really fun. The launch and top hat is the highlight of the ride, for sure. This is a ride, this is a bucket list ride for me for years, and I'm glad I got to ride it. It was really fun. I didn't think I would have the chance to ride it because it was close, but good thing it was open. I had a great time on it, even though it disappointed me a little bit. Still a great ride. Number 7 is Backlot Stunt Coaster at Canada's Wonderland. This really surprised me. It was a lot better than I thought it would be. I thought it would be more of like a family ride, which it is, but it's more aggressive than I thought it would be. It's really intense with the helixes. And then when you're indoors, dark, you can't see anything. That's a really fun part. I got some airtime in there. It gave me like that drop feeling in my stomach. It was really fun. It blew my mind. The launch wasn't too impressive, but it was more fun than I thought it would be. And yeah, really good ride. Number 6 is Yukon Striker at Canada's Wonderland. I have this at number 2 in the park, and then I dropped it down to number 3 because I realized that I was over exaggerating. It's a really fun ride. It's better than Valraven, which is the only other dive coaster I've ridden. It's really fun. The vest restraints aren't too restrictive, and the drop's really good into the tunnel. And it was the second day open, so it wasn't really complete, but it was still really fun. And I really like it. So, number 5 is Leviathan at Canada's Wonderland. this, I moved up to number 2 in the park. I don't really remember too much about it. It's not really too memorable. It's got good float airtime hills. The drop wasn't as good as I was expecting. I've heard that it was one of the best drops, like, close to Fury's, but I didn't see that at all. I was underwhelmed by it, but it was still really fun. Still one of the better drops, I would say, that I've experienced. And the speed hill didn't really do much for me, but it's a pretty short ride, and that turn around is pretty good, too. But number 4 is Racer Kennywood. This is so underrated. Airtime on every single hill. Especially when you loosen your seatbelt. You just get flung out of your seats. The restraints make it really easy for that. I think this deserves way more appreciation than it gets. I just don't think that it should get that much hate. It's not a bad ride. I was gonna put it over the next ride that I have on here, but I don't know. I guess you could tie both of them, but I just decided to put the other one higher. This one's really close though. One of my favorite rides, top 10 that I've ridden currently. So number 3 is Jackrabbit at Kennywood. The only reason this is above it is because of that one moment. Although, on Racer, the one moment, the final hill before the brakes, that's the reason why I would put that above this, which, I don't know, that's it. These are really close. This airtime hill is really good, especially we were loosening the seatbelts a lot. It was really fun. We were, like, taking our shirts off on the mid-ride. It was just really weird. It was really fun. We were, like, standing up on it. And then, to add on top of that, the double-down airtime hill. It was kind of dumb, but it was really fun, and, we're still here, so it's not that dumb, really. Think about it. Number 2 is Behemoth at Canada's Wonderland. This is a really good ride. I expected this to be my favorite at Canada's Wonderland. I expected the floater airtime hills to be really good, as I was expecting. And the ejector airtime hills. All of them hit the spot for me. All great. All better than Leviathan. It's a longer ride. It's better airtime. And, well, besides the long floater airtime on Leviathan. Well, that's really the only floater airtime on Leviathan. That's really why Behemoth is better, because it has way more. Through a lot of them, a lot of elements on Behemoth are better than some of the elephants. Elements on Leviathan. So, the Helix is really intense, and I like their strengths. Same as Leviathan, but still. And then number 1 is Phantom's Revenge. Ejector airtime all the way. I love it so much. It flung me out of the seat a lot, and the second drop is way better. It's really intense. You got good views. I love the views on this. It's a short ride, but it's a great ride, and definitely the best new coaster that I've ridden in 2019. So I'll see you guys next time. Have a great 2020. Goodbye.
I don't know what's going on. What's going on?
What?
What are we doing?
We had to go ride Ride of Steel about 100 more times.
Aren't you getting food?
Was going to.
Bro, stop. Stop.
Freak, man.
Oh! Nighttime. Oh. We got a nighttime ride on Ride of Steel. We're going towards Motocoaster. He has to do Skystreamer.